Could intellectual property rights be the cause of global warming? After all, the greatest inventions of the two last centuries include the car, the plane, and with them the use of oil and coal to generate energy. They are some of the causes that contribute the most to the increase of levels of CO2 on the planet. The academic community has given very little attention, if any, to this increasingly important issue. It is time, however, that the national and international intellectual property systems and treaties be reassessed in view of this problem that touches every human being. The paper explores the role that intellectual property rights play in regulating pollution levels, especially levels of greenhouse gases. Intellectual property statutes are certainly not in essence responsible for global warming and pollution. They can be seen as neutral, as their aim is simply to give an incentive to invent new technologies or create original works or designs. For instance, Article 1, Section 8, Clause 8 of the U.S. Constitution simply enables Congress to promote the progress of science and useful arts. In some cases already, intellectual property statutes may indirectly help the environment. For instance, compulsory licenses exist if an invention is not put to practice, allowing anyone to commercialize an environmentally friendly invention. The paper argues that whilst the current intellectual property systems already indirectly take the respect of the environment into account, they could be improved if one wishes to further reduce CO2 emissions. The public order and compulsory licensing rules could be improved. Also, if one admits that intellectual property rights are human rights, and there seems to be a general consensus on this issue now, they must be balanced against other human rights which may mandate a healthy environment. The paper analyses these issues in turn and makes some recommendations to modify intellectual property laws accordingly. Because land surfaces heat faster than ocean surfaces, deserts are expanding and heat waves and wildfires are more common. Surface temperature rise is greatest in the Arctic, where it has contributed to melting permafrost and the retreat of glaciers and sea ice. Increasing atmospheric energy and rates of evaporation cause more intense storms and weather extremes, which damage infrastructure and agriculture. Rising temperatures are limiting ocean productivity and harming fish stocks in most parts of the globe. Current and anticipated effects from undernutrition, heat stress, and disease have led the World Health Organization to declare climate change the greatest threat to global health in the 21st century. Environmental effects include the extinction or relocation of many species as their ecosystems change, most immediately in coral reefs, mountains, and the Arctic. Even if efforts to minimize future warming are successful, some effects will continue for centuries, including rising sea levels, rising ocean temperatures, and ocean acidification from elevated levels of CO2. Multiple independently produced instrumental datasets show that the climate system is warming, with the 2009-2018 decade being 0.93 plus or minus 0.07 degrees Celsius, 1.67 plus or minus 0.13 degrees Fahrenheit, warmer than the pre-industrial baseline, 1850-1900. Currently, surface temperatures are rising by about 0.2 degrees Celsius, 0.36 degrees Fahrenheit, per decade. Since 1950, the number of cold days and nights has decreased, and the number of warm days and nights has increased. Historical patterns of warming and cooling, like the medieval climate anomaly and the Little Ice Age, were not as synchronous across regions as current warming, but may have reached temperatures as high as those of the late 20th century in a limited set of regions. There have been prehistorical episodes of global warming, such as the Paleocene, Eocene thermal maximum. However, the observed rise in temperature and CO2 concentrations has been so rapid that even abrupt geophysical events that took place in Earth's history do not approach current rates. Climate proxy records show that natural variations offset the early effects of the Industrial Revolution, so there was little net warming between the 18th century and the mid-19th century. The Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, IPCC, has adopted the baseline reference period 1850-1900 as an approximation of pre-industrial global mean surface temperature, when thermometer records began to provide global coverage. Tell what your thoughts on this topic. Global warming refers to global averages, with the amount of warming varying by region. Patterns of warming are independent of the locations of greenhouse gas emissions, because the gases persist long enough to diffuse across the planet, However, localized black carbon deposits on snow and ice do contribute to Arctic warming. Since the pre-industrial period, global average land temperatures have increased almost twice as fast as global average surface temperatures. This is because of the larger heat capacity of oceans, and because oceans lose more heat by evaporation. Over 90% of the additional energy in the climate system over the last 50 years has been stored in the ocean, warming it. The remainder of the additional energy has melted ice and warmed the continents and the atmosphere. The ocean heat uptake drives thermal expansion, which has contributed to observed sea level rise. Do you think global warming can be prevented? Do you think that we can prevent it? And if yes, how so? Like the video if you like it. Share it. And subscribe to our channel for more content.